I started singing, actually, folk music in the 60s when it had its huge revival. And I met Guy Clark, as a matter of fact, in Houston. We formed a trio, singing some songs for a while. It was Dave and Kay and Guy. And then Dave and Kay went off their own, and Guy went off on his own. And I sang in Houston for a while with the folk music craze. And then I went to, I auditioned for a, I got into some theater work in Houston, musical theater. And from that, I also moved to New York, where I did Broadway theater for a couple of years. Then I got a piano, was given a piano. I started to write music. And about a year after I started to write, I somehow got down to Nashville to do some writing with people like Rory Burke and Charlie Black, Jerry Gillespie. So I thought the rule of thumb with business is you never use your own money, right? Even if I had some money, I wouldn't have used it, but I thought I'd go by the rule of thumb. So I borrowed some money, I put together a band, and I came down to Nashville for one day and did a showcase. Live showcase, and I invited everybody I could find in the business. And I got to Harold Shedd, producer of Alabama, Glenn Campbell, Dobie Gray. And Harold and I came to a publishing deal agreement. And he says, well, what do you want to do about this singing business? And I said, well, I'd like to do this singing business. And, straight to you, I'll never get too far away from you. I'm never gonna get too lost, oh, that I can't be found. And I'm never gonna swim too far out, 'cause I sure don't want to drown. Just wanna come back. Working with Harold Shedd is a dream come true. Harold is a real song man. He's not just a producer who goes, oh, well, I make records and I boost the bass and you sing this and I do this. Harold recognizes a song when he hears it. He doesn't necessarily always think in terms of singles. You can get single hammered to death in this business. Single, 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 it's a single, it's a single. You know, well, how about a real well-rounded album? Well, what are the singles? Harold sees beyond that, so he and I connected on a writing level right away. There are forms of music that are, of course, indigenous to America. Jazz, blues, American folk, country, rock and roll. These are all what we call our Native American music. We originated these styles here. And I've grown up listening to all of them and like all of them. So when I sat down to write, or when I started to become a writer, all of these things that I've just listened to, just like the normal people do all my life, they all came together into my music. A little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bit of this. And then I've put it together the way I do it. I've actually only pitched about 5 songs. And the first one that I pitched was a song called Round the Clock Lovin'. Gail Davies. Thank you, Gail. Charlie McLean did. Gail also cut Where's a Woman to Go. Dottie West also cut Where's a Woman to Go. Charlie McLean cut I'll Get You Back. Sissy Spacek had the single. I had the single off of her album, Lonely But Only for You. Oh, yeah, and then I have a really great new thing that's on the Judd's new album, Heartland, called Old Pictures. Jerry Gillespie and I wrote that song. We wrote that song, as a matter of fact, for the Judds. It's the only time I've ever done that. I've never sat down and wrote a song for someone. But we did do it with that one for them. The song 80s Ladies, that's a real baby of mine. We were three little girls from school. One was pretty, one was smart, and one was a borderline fool. The smart one used her head, and she made her fortune. And me, well, I crossed the border just about every chance I get. A very dear friend of mine, we went all the way through school. We were the very, very best of friends. And of course, like the old stuff goes, when we got out of school and started to work and this and that, and she got married, and she got divorced, and she got married, and she got divorced, and I went here and I went there, and she moved across the country and I moved this way. So years and years go by when we don't get to see each other. And a couple of years ago, she sent me a letter just to sort of keep me, you know, in touch with what was going on. And I opened it up, and out fell a picture of her daughter, current picture of her daughter who was 10. And it was a clone of my girlfriend at the age of 10. It was like looking at her. She had her father's nose. She didn't have my friend's nose. But it was like, there was my girlfriend. I felt 10 years old when I looked at that picture. And I thought, gee, you know, we went through a lot of years together. We did a lot of things. How nice. And I thought, these three women just sort of came into my head. Having lunch. Whether it be the first time they've seen each other in 15 years, or they just saw each other last week, or they haven't seen each other in 6 months, or whatever the time period, these people will always reconnect very quickly. They're very dear friends. They have old, strong ties. So I wanted to write a song about these women sitting at lunch and just starting to yammer about what it is.
Oh, we signed I do, and we signed I don't. We've sworn we'd never do that again. Well, we've